Hey, we're the Crafty Lumberjacks.
You know, this year we were on the nice list.
Yes.
And our friends at Work Tools sent us their new Maker X.
Yes, it's a portable, battery-operated crafter's dream.
Yes, it all connects into this main hub here, and they have five different attachments. They have a heat gun, an angle grinder,
a rotary tool, a wood-burning tool,
and our favorite, the airbrush.
Yes,
we got to try out the tools before anyone else, and we decided to get crafty for the holidays.
In this video, we're going to show you five easy DIYs using the Maker X.
For our first project, we wanted to make a vintage-inspired rustic box.
The first thing we did was use the angle grinder to distress the edges. We really wanted to rough it up a bit and make it look like it's been used for years.
Then we gave it a coat of paint using just acrylic paint.
And then we added a stencil that we cut out with our Cricut Maker, and then we used the airbrush.
So cool. We always recommend testing your airbrush before actually airbrushing your item. We airbrushed right over our stencil, peeled it off.
It looks so great. And then we used the rotary tool just to add some light distressing. We didn't want to take too much of the paint away, but we wanted to, you know, sand it down just a little bit.
We threw in some festive flourishes. Looked so good.
This project has been around for a while, but it's all about the image you find. Find an image online and then tape a piece of tissue paper to a piece of printer paper.
Print out your image on the tissue paper and then cut it out. You want to cut close to the edge of your image and then just use the tissue paper.
And lay it right on top of an LED battery-operated candle and then put a piece of wax paper around it.
You want to hold it pretty tightly and then use your heat gun to start transferring the tissue paper to the candle. It's kind of magic. It's a Christmas miracle.
You can actually see it.
Yes, transform as you're heating it up. Be careful while you're working. It does get a little hot. You can always wear gloves and then remove your wax paper. We love this vintage old school Santa vibe.
So
it looks so great.
Ho ho ho! A lot of you know we met on the national tour of Fiddler on the Roof, so we decided to try to make a dreidel.
Yes, we found the center point of our wood block and then drilled a little hole there, and then we kind of roughly just drew where we wanted to sand down with our angle grinder. We put in a clamp just to secure it.
And then we started to sand it down. Now, the lines we made weren't steep enough to give us a point, but you know, we were just trying it out. We really didn't know how this was gonna turn out, but we eventually did get this nice rounded edge, which looked really great.
Yeah, we just kept working at it. We stuck a wooden dowel in the hole that we drilled and then cut it down with our rotary tool, and then another stencil with the Cricut Maker.
And then to keep things clean, we just added painter's tape to the rest of the dreidel. And then we added paint to our airbrush and then just started airbrushing the stencil.
Oh, dreidel, 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 I made it out of wood?
The real test was going to be if it actually worked, which we didn't know if it was gonna work. It's coming up.
Oh my gosh.
Look at this reveal, it looks so good.
Clean lines, wow. It works!
To life, l'chaim!
Well, we're the lumberjacks, so we always have to have a tree project.
First, we cut out some tree shapes out of felt and then folded them in half.
Yes, we use our rotary cutter to actually cut down wood skewers that we got at the dollar store to use for our trunks.
Yep, and then we just swapped out the bits and then drilled holes straight down into wood rounds.
One of the coolest features about the Maker X is that you can raise and lower the speed depending on what project you're working on.
Then we just added a little glue to the top of the wood skewer and then started adding in our felt trees.
Pop them into the base there and we had an instant forest.
Timber! Just kidding.
We're obsessed with how this project turned out. We're making wood-burn gift tags.
Now, we found an image online and then just used some carbon paper to transfer the image onto the wood.
Yeah, we actually pre-bought these wood gift tags at Michael's.
Yep.
And then we started to wood-burn our image.
Yeah, you want to hold the wood-burning tool like a pencil.
And turn the wood piece as you work rather than your hand.
And then we added some watercolor to really make the image pop. And it also helps hide some imperfections.
Yes, wood-burning is a skill and takes time and you have to practice. Then we added some buffalo plaid ribbon. They look so great, modern, fresh.
These would look so festive on a package or even as ornaments.
It's time for mistletoe and holly.
You know, making these DIYs really got us into the holiday spirit.
Yes, maybe if you weren't naughty this year, you might get yourself a Maker X too. I was channeling Santa.
Yes, well, naughty or nice, we hope we brought you some crafty holiday inspo.
Yes, we want to hear from you. What was your favorite project in a comment below? And we're definitely going to be sharing more throughout the holiday season. And we hope to see you soon.
Bye.
It's that special time of year of lights and tree decor. The crafty lumberjacks have DIYs galore. Add tchotchkes all around to brighten up your space. Their fab ideas and hacks will marry up.
up the place. Oh, happy, happy holidays from Dennis and Andrew. These New York chaps have the crafty chops to make the season pop. Get your glue gun, grab some snacks, pull out your cricket too. The crafty lumberjacks are here to spend some time with you.
Happy holidays!